Run faster. Let's go.
Yo, I can't believe Coach Carr gave us a D in gym class.
It's totally not fair. We put in so much work for this class.
And, like, I'm taking a molecular genetics course. It's kicking my ass, and I need this A for the GPA.
Oh, I know, man. Yo, what's your high score on Candy Crush?
Worst part is, I heard Hester was the only person who got an A in the class.
Yeah, she's probably hooking up with a coach or something.
Yeah, probably.
Guys, did you just see Coach Carr slip Hester that weird love note? Sketchy.
Was I right or was I right?
Oh shit, yo, we should go talk to Principal Christensen.
Yeah, let's go. Okay,
let's go.
Just a second. Come on in. What can I do for you kids?
Hey, Principal Christensen. We have a big problem regarding Coach Carr and Hester. They've been having sex with each other, and she's managed to convince him that the entire class deserves D's, and she deserves an A. And it's entirely unfair.
It has to be against the rules or something, right?
Like, is there anything you can do for us?
I'm well aware of the policy regarding Hester having relationships with anyone besides other students.
So does that mean you can help us and get us our A's?
I'd like to help you kids out, but you gotta show me some evidence.
I guess we're going to have to figure something out.
Okay.
All right. Thank you so much for seeing us, Principal Christensen.
You're welcome. And remember, kids, stay in school and don't do drugs.
Yes, sir.
Hey, guys. How'd it go with Principal Christensen?
Oh, it went well. He said he'll help us, but he needs proof. So we're going to have a meeting in the biology room at 3 p.m.
Yeah, so gather everyone up that you know that got a D, and we'll meet in the class.
Okay.
Okay.
See you soon.
What the fuck is essential dogma?
Come on, guys, we gotta focus.
We need to somehow prove that Coach Carr and Hester are having extracurricular activities.
Okay, but like, how do you prove an interaction if you can't see it?
Guys, this sounds a lot like a yeast 2 hybrid assay. You know about yeast 2 hybrid assays, right? All right, I'll show you.
It is so amazing. It will let you detect if two proteins are interacting without being able to see them directly or anything like that.
This gene is called the reporter gene because its expression will report to us that our two proteins interact. You just insert the reporter gene near an upstream activation sequence, or UAS, in a plasmid that you put into the cells of an appropriate host organism, such as this assay's namesake, yeast. You need to break down the UAS's transactivator protein into its DNA binding and transcription activating domains and attach each of these to one of your proteins of interest using a linker. The protein you attach to the DNA binding domain will be called the bait, and the other will be called the prey. These linked sets of proteins are the hybrids that this assay's name refers to. At first, the DNA binding domain will just be hanging out on the UAS, bound to the bait, and not doing anything. If your bait and prey bind, the prey will bring the transcription activating domain close to the DNA binding domain so that you end up with a whole functioning transactivator. Your reporter gene will then be upregulating, letting you know that your proteins bind.
Is that not amazing?
But like, okay, what does that have to do with Hester and Coach Carr?
What does that have to do with Hester and Coach Carr? Well,
imagine Hester is the bait and Coach Carr is the prey. If we could attach something to each of them that would give us some sort of signal when brought together, we could detect if they were having some sort of interaction, where they come into close proximity. The only issue is, I don't know what we could use.
Right. It sounds like the thing that I'm doing for school dance. It has two parts. So if I mix them together, it will show up under the UV light.
Oh, so like if we spray it on their clothes, then when they go to extracurricular, it'll mix together.
Oh, and at the school dance, if you could get them on stage, I could totally turn on the black light.
Then we can expose these hoes.
Yeah, expose these hoes. Expose these hoes.
Expose these hoes. Expose these hoes. Expose these hoes. Expose these hoes. Expose these hoes. Expose these hoes. Expose these hoes. Expose these hoes. Expose these hoes. Expose these hoes.
Okay guys, here I have the two parts of the paint. They are invisible, but if you mix them, it will glow under the black light.
Okay, so we'll take one part, you guys take the other part. We'll take care of Esther's clothes, you guys get Coach Carr.
Okay, awesome.
Alright, we'll meet at the dance tonight then. Wrong way!
Is this her locker?
I think so.
What are you even doing here?
Oh my god. Girl, you should have been at the meeting yesterday.
I'm sorry. I was at the doctor's office.
Okay, whatever. So, we're doing this thing called yeast 2 hybrid acid.
Oh, I have one of those. That's why I was at the gynecologist.
Oh my god. Just start spraying.
Okay.
Spray, spray, spray. What are you guys doing? Hey! We didn't want to tell you, but you kind of stink. So we were trying to help you out. This is Febreze. Like, smell how fresh this smells, right? Do you smell that freshness?
Smells.
It's really fresh.
Thanks.
Yeah. Yeah.
That was close.
That was too close. I hope it's going better for the guys.
Ow, you got it in my face.
So?
Bruh, what are you doing?
I have faith in them.
Really?
Yeah.
Alright, ready for your signal, guys.
Welcome, Binghamton High School students, to our annual winter ball. I'd like to invite our class president.
What's her name?
Oh, Jenny O.
Thank you, Principal Christensen, and welcome students. It's that moment you've all been waiting for. We're going to announce the king and queen of the winter ball. Drum roll, please. It's Hester P. and Coach Carr.
Jenny, isn't a student and a teacher not allowed?
You would think so, wouldn't you? But some of us this year have been ho-ho-hos.
And now let's welcome them to the stage.
Expose these hoes. 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 Expose these hoes.
And here they are, exposed at last.
Push
them
together.
So they can get jealous. And if you see a foe, I do. Tell I wish that I turn on the light. I'm looking
forward. What the fuck?
What the hell? Your experiment didn't work.
Actually, guys, it did work. Just like in the yeast 2 hybrid assay, if there isn't an interaction, you won't observe any sort of signal from your reporter. In this case, it's like we set up two different yeast 2 hybrid assays, but the one that reported interaction was just not the one we expected to.
Shut up, nerd. Coach Carr, if you're not hitting that, why is she the only one getting an A?
Well, I'll tell you, Principal Christensen. They spend all their time in class sucking at life and doing this. Damn cell phones.
So what about that love letter Coach Carr gave you?
What, this one?
Yeah, that.